Hey, what's up guys? My name is Alex and I am back with another video, and today I'm giving 5 tips for anyone who is wanting to start out in wedding filmmaking. Tip number 1, coverage. Coverage is extremely important when filming a live event, especially a wedding. There are key moments that happen during the day that are spontaneous and they cannot be recreated. You don't get a second take at the first kiss or the first look. These things, you have to make sure you're prepared and you are ready to cover them from multiple angles. I suggest bringing multiple cameras to the event, at least 3. That way you are covered. If for some reason you forget to hit record on one camera, at least you have 2 backup angles to choose from. Also, having someone there with you, like a second shooter, or at least somebody to assist you during the day, I think is extremely important as well. Some people do weddings solo and, you know, they're brave souls, but having somebody there to help you, either by helping you shoot the day or just helping you to carry your equipment and get set up during the day, it is definitely a bonus. Tip number 2 is communicating with other vendors. This one is extremely important because we all know that sometimes there are these rivalries between photographers and videographers and DJs, and there really doesn't need to be. We are all there for one purpose, and that is to serve the couple that hired us. They are our clients and we are there to make their day great. So fighting with each other is definitely not making their day great. So I highly suggest you communicate with the other vendors working the event, either the photographer or the DJ, throughout the day. Make sure you tell them what you're doing during a ceremony. Let the photographer know where you're gonna be and try to not to be intrusive. Figuring out a game plan so you're not in each other's way is going to not only make the day smoother, but it's also going to form a better relationship between you and that photographer. Tip number 3, creating relationships between you and your couple. I highly suggest that you take the time out to meet with your couple, either in person or over the phone, and just get to know them a little bit. Get to know how they met, what their story is. Tell them how you work and what they can expect from you during the day. Tip number 4 is lighting. I think it's extremely important to light your subjects, especially during the reception, during the dancing, during the toast, and anywhere you can actually get away with setting up lights, it's important to do so. And that's just because it makes the footage look so much better. I know there are plenty of cameras that are great in low light, and that's awesome. But even if your camera is great in low light, adding light to your scene is only gonna make that footage pop. And finally, tip number 5, my last tip, and the most important tip of all, good audio. Good audio drives your story. People will forgive bad footage, but they will never forgive bad audio. Having the couple read letters that they wrote to each other will add a personal touch. Hearing the toast in the highlight film will also add another personal touch. It'll drive a story, and story is extremely important in wedding films. Well, this concludes the video, guys. I hope this helps if you are considering jumping into the wedding film industry. Weddings can be very challenging, but they are also very rewarding at the same time. And if you are looking to improve your craft as a filmmaker, there is nothing that will improve it faster than wedding filmmaking. If you like this video, make sure you hit the subscribe button below and the like button. I have more videos planned for the future. I have more gear reviews. Right now I'm shooting this using the iLED gear space light modifier for the aperture LS1. That was a mouthful. And I plan on doing a review on that soon in the future, so make sure you subscribe.